Well, back here at home, it was an unveiling of a new 9/11 memorial on the Treasure Coast. As Chris McGrath tells us, it has a very personal meaning for those who lost loved ones.
This new 9/11 memorial unveiled this morning here in Port St. Lucie during a special ceremony. I want to walk you through some of the features. You can see the focal point is actually a steel beam from one of the twin towers that's pointing towards Manhattan. It's mounted on a base shaped like the Pentagon. Water flows over the names of all the victims of 9/11. And this green marble represents the grassy field in Shanksville, Pennsylvania, where United Flight 93 went down. For those who lost a loved one 11 years ago, this is becoming a special place.
Some place that I have now that I can just come and say hi.
Kim McDonald stops by this 9/11 memorial in Port St. Lucie to say hi to her cousin, Jeffrey Dwayne Coleman.
He's a flight attendant on American Airlines Flight 11, and that is, of course, the first plane to crash into the trade centers.
Jeffrey switched flights to be on that plane, heading from Los Angeles to New York City. At 8:46 a.m., it slammed into the World Trade Center's North Tower. 11 years later, the memories come flooding back, just as fresh as the day itself.
You know, every year you think it's going to get better. And it feels like it right up until the day.
A day filled with sadness and grief. Not many dry eyes in Port St. Lucie. And as we pause to remember the victims of 9/11, 11 years later, new, young faces have joined the crowd. Many barely old enough to realize what happened.
And that's the whole message today, is for our youth to never forget what happened and to make sure it never happens again.
This memorial was built by volunteers using donated materials. It's been named September 11th Memorial Plaza to serve as a permanent reminder of all the lives lost 11 years ago. In Port St. Lucie, Chris McGrath, WPBF 25 News.